Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan selamat sejahtera dan selamat malam. Alhamdulillah kita bertemu lagi dalam kelas mengaji tulis artikel jurnal untuk level yang kedua untuk siri yang ke-19 hingga ke-23. Maksudnya saya himpunkan untuk siri yang ke-19 sehingga 23 kerana tema dia sama, iaitu tema dia however. Tapi perbincangan however ni dalam penulisan artikel jurnal di literature review. Kita terus kepada siri yang ke-19. Okey, yang pertama tajuk dia adalah Conceptual Framework and Linkage Between Social Capitals and Disaster Preparedness, A Case of Orang Asli Families in Malaysia. Di sini perenggan yang kita nak bincangkan penggunaan perkataan however tu. Okay, dia ada panjang dimulakan. The study has selected Tasik Chini as the area is most affected by frequent disaster and not comprehensive study regarding social capital and disaster preparedness has been associated with the location and the people living in it. Panjang kan? Jadi pakcik ambil ayat yang bawah tu. Dia ada blah 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 blah. There are five village in Tasik Chini such as Kampung Gumun, Kampung Melai, Kampung Cenahan, Kampung Ulu Gumun and Kampung Ulu Melai. Okay. However, Kampung Gumun was selected for this study as most of the orang asli people live in this village. Okay. Idea dia simple je nak beritahu. Okay, kita ada lima kampung, contohnya di Tasik Chini. So, ada lima kampung di sini, ada Kampung Gumun, Kampung Melai, Kampung Cenahan, Kampung Hulu and Kampung Hulu Melai. However, Kampung Gumun was selected for this study and most of the orang asli people live in this village. Dia kena beritahu ada lima kampung dan dia beritahu dia pilih satu kampung dan beri justifikasilah kenapa kampung itu dia. Okay, kita pergi yang contoh kedua, tajuk dia A Case Study of Micro Business in Jelutong Wet Market in Penang, Penang Malaysia, Implication for CSR Scholarship. Cik ulang balik. A Case Study of Micro Business in Jelutong Wet Market in Penang, of Penang Malaysia, Implication for CSR Scholarship. Okay, perenggan dia, pakcik ambil ayat yang related yang atas tu. These three theories establish the cornerstone of the modern social capital theories. Today, concept of social capital, however, is result of the mixture of functionalist, critical and rational theoretical traditions. Jadi, dia nak cerita berkaitan dengan dalam kesnya ada tiga teori lah. Tetapi dia nak beritahu dalam konteks social capital theory. Tapi dia beritahu sekarang ni, keadaan currently, recently sekarang ni dia katakan today's concept of social capital, however, is result mixture of functionalist, critical and rational theoretical traditions. So, dia tekankan konsep social capital tu sendiri. Okay, dengan keadaan sekarang. Okay, sekarang yang ketiga, artikel kita yang ketiga bertajuk Planner Perspective on Governing and Producing Sustainable Cities in Malaysia. Kita tengok perenggan ni ambil yang dekat dengan penggunaan however ni lah. Okay, mula-mula dari atas. Research has examined the mechanism for measuring and monitoring sustainable developments, environmental protection, the promotion of human welfare and well-being, including the urgent needs of alleviate poverty and human settlement and community developments. However, little research has been conducted into the role of local governments in promoting sustainable cities in developing countries such as Malaysia. Jadi kat sini nak beritahu kekurangan lah. Gap lah kat sini nak beritahu yang kurangnya penyelidikan dalam local government ni nak promote sustainable cities. Contohnya di Malaysia. Okay. Boleh belajar. Jadi sebab tu pakcik tunjukkan contoh by contoh. Banyak contoh kita ini. Jadi kita boleh belajar penggunaan however. Okay, tajuk berikutnya, CEO age and risk taking of family business in Malaysia, the inverse S-curve relationship. Pakcik ambil satu perenggan ni. In the beginning of career life, younger CEOs have higher tendency to undertake more aggressive investment policy to signal their superior ability. However, beyond a certain age threshold, the tendency of taking risk is likely to be influenced more significant by career horizon effects. Kat sini nak cerita berkaitan dengan young CEO lah. Regarding apa? Ambil high tendency to take more aggressive investment policy. So dia suka ambil risk taker lah kat sini. However, beyond certain age threshold, the tendency of taking risk is likely, yang ni dia nak mention ni, is likely to influence more significantly by carry horizon effects. Okay, kat sini digunakan however dalam memberi penjelasan lah. Eh? Okay, yang kelima, tajuk artikel kita, awareness, knowledge, attitude. So ni sebut AKA lah. Kalau tak biasa, tapi kalau dah biasa, dia tahu dalam bidang ni. Awareness, knowledge, attitude, dia panggil AKA. Of government secondary school student on the use of antibiotic in Shah Alam, Malaysia. Okay, this is due to less awareness, knowledge and attitude, aka regarding the usage of drug among the public. However, this issue can also be trigger of, However, this issue can also be trigger if antibiotic are abused and overused. Jadi dia menyatakan itu. Kita terus kepada yang keenam. Kita dah boleh laju kan? Jadi faham kan kenapa pakcik nak tekankan perkataan however tu. Supaya awak boleh belajar macam mana nak tulis however. Sebab however penting kan dalam penulisan artikel, kerana menekankan kita nak strengthenkan hujah kita. Kita nak buat reflection. Okay, kalau keadaan semasa macam ni, so apa yang you nak tekankan dengan keadaan terkini? So kalau orang lain dapat A je, you nak beritahu walau bagaimanapun, however, kita ada juga yang B. So penting perkataan however ni. Okay, tajuk seterusnya adalah understanding and opinion of sustainable development among youths in higher education institution in Penang, Malaysia. Okay, walaupun paper ni adalah diterbitkan oleh publisher luar negara, tapi pakcik ambil contoh yang kajian di Malaysia. Eh. So di sini ada dua perkataan however. Pakcik ambil contoh dua-dua. Dua perenggan ni. Several study concerns sustainable development specifically among youth have been published. However, the result of this study were found to be very. Maksudnya walaupun dah banyak kajian ni dah dibuat, tetapi kajian-kajian mereka, dapatan-dapatan kajian mereka tu menemukan perbezaan. Okay. Satu lagi ya, di bawah tu, on examination of student concept map and interviews, respondent had more detailed understanding of sustainability in interview than was expressed in their concept map. However, it was clear that there is a wide understanding of sustainability among the respondent. Okay, itu dia highlight lah. Okay. Okay, kita pergi tajuk ketujuh, mock instructor design and challenge. What can be learned from existing MOOC in Indonesia and Malaysia? MOOC tu maksud dia yang itulah, massive open online course. Okay, saya ambil satu ayat ni yang nak tekankan however ni. In a study by Zhu et al, the challenge of MOOC design consisted of finding an organization quality contents for use with thousands of participants, creating instructional support, opening up access while also offering autonomy and control the student and providing timely feedback. However, the existing literature in this area offers suggestions to instructor for solving the design challenge, such as turning to stakeholders, assessing available published journal and report, and utilizing application that give guidance on course design. Jadi dia nak jelaskanlah MOOC dalam literature area suggest. Okay. Jadi kita akan menggunakan however bila kita nak menekankan sesuatu tentang perkara tu. Okay, tajuk yang kelapai, why girl get married early in Sarawak, Malaysia? And exploratory qualitative study. Ya. Tengok kenapa lah ramai perempuan di Sarawak kahwin awal. Exploratory qualitative study. Okay, kita ambil satu ayat kat sini. Thus, child marriage is considered a human right violation within the international community by such organizations such the World Health Organization, WHO, and the United Nations. However, The factor contributing the child marriage may differ, as they are shaped by the social culture context of each country and region. Betul lah. Memanglah kita membincangkan tentang perkahwinan muda ni dah sudut worldwide. Tetapi sesuatu perkara itu akan berlaku berbeza, berbezalah dari segi konteks sesebuah negara tu, especially dalam social culture dan juga agama. Okay, tajuk yang ke-9, the relationship between the workplace, spirituality and work to family enrichment in selected public sector organization in Malaysia. Okay, kita tengok satu perenggan ni. According Krishna Kumar and Nick, workplace spirituality has variety of definition that have been suggested. So, ada pelbagai definisi. However, it is commonly defined as the recognition that employees have an inner life that nourish and nourished by meaningful work that take place in the context of community. Walaupun ada banyak banyak definisi, tapi kebiasaan commonly definisi digunakan adalah kat situ digunakan. Okay, tajuk yang ke-10, a confirmatory factor analysis of behavior attention to use smart wellness wearable in Malaysia. Okay, kat sini kita ambil ni kan, however tu, saya bacakan dari sini dulu. Ni memang perenggan panjang lah, pakcik ambil yang perkataan satu, perkataan awal sebelum however dan perkataan however tu sendiri. Okay, nanti you all can refer slide. Therefore, it's important to explore the particular requirement and preference of user who own wearable for the purpose of wellness tracking and to determine the priority of general public in various country. However, recent research, macam tadi jugalah, today, terkini ni, recent research study on user acceptance of wearables have examined a limited number of critical factors from technology perspective. Okay. Bukan sekarang ni, orang menumpukan. Kita juga ke-11, the diversity of traditional Malay kuih in Malaysia and its potential. Pakcik suka paper ni. Nanti kalau you all nak, nanti request. Kadang pakcik lupa kan. Nanti saya pakcik akan bagi artikel ni. Artikel ni menarik kan. Okay. Understanding sustainability issue, the youngest generation is undoubtedly coming into mind as the next generation to inherit and reproduce traditional Malay kuih sustainability. However, has reached that there are prevalence challenge to sustain traditional Malay kuih in the youth. Maksudnya, kita tahu pelbagai macam-macam keenakan kuih tradisional di Malaysia, tapi kuih-kuih ni mungkin tidak dikenali oleh kalangan muda lah. So, how you nak sustain traditional kuih in Malaysia? Okay. Tajuk yang ke-12, a preliminary insight into the environmental awareness of community in the vicinity of batik manufacturing unit in Kelantan, Malaysia. Okay, dia gunakan however dekat ayat ni. The finding implied a shallow awareness regarding the batik manufacturing process and chemical property of dye used in the colouring process among the participants. However, more than half of them were observed to be aware of the wastewater disposal method and associated environmental and health impact of the wastewater discharge. Okay, no. Next, Amanah and Muslim identity, relationship with religious and psychological adjustment in Malaysia. Okay, the finding imply a shallow awareness regarding the, okay sorry, yang ni rasanya ada kesilapan sikit sebab ni okay betul lah, okay tajuk dia. Ni patut dia. Interest ni tajuk ni kita mustahil Amanah and Muslim Identity lah. So ni perenggan dia macam tertekan ke atas pula. Okay, interestingly, however, jadi perkataan however digunakan di ayat-ayat awal dalam perenggan. Interestingly, however, a possible cause also appear to accompany extrinsic culture commitment. Jadi boleh juga gunakan perkataan however, perkataan yang kedua dalam perenggan ni. Okay, terus ni tajuk ke-14, appraisal of student awareness and practice on waste management and recycling in the Malaysia University Student Hostel area. So kita ambil perenggan ni. Proper waste management via 3R, iaitu reduce, reuse and recycle, carry out by good governance hold that key toward sustainable society and can potentially reduce and need for new landfills, recycle food waste and fertilizer in returning nutrition into the topsoil and reduce greenhouse gas, CHG emissions from landfills. However, SWM remain one of the main environmental challenge in developing country, which include Malaysia. Penting ni kita nak tengok perkara ni di Malaysia. Okay, tajuk ke-15, Innovation Management Practice Review Guidance for Future Research SME. Simple tajuk dia. Okay, considering the above, sebab kita ambil perenggan pilihan kan, considering the above with regards to innovation management, the literature review has highlighted the particularities of management in SME versus large company. Many study analysis this issue in large company. However, there is less literature available that collect the driver of innovation practice in SME. Kan? Kalau macam you menghadapi masalah yang sama, yang maksudnya walaupun topik ini menjadi topik perempuan tapi kurang dalam literature review, you boleh gunakan ayat ini. However, there is less literature available that collects the driver of innovation practice in SME. Ya, tajuk ke-16, the immediate effect of enterprise risk management implementation on operational excellence in the Malaysia oil gas sector, a conceptual framework. Okay, as a result of the above challenge, some of the major IOC adopted OE, which has significantly improved efficiency in their operation. However, even the most successful OE program needs improvement because new regulations are enacted, new risks are emerging, employees are demanding for healthier and safe working environment, and new tools and technologies are discovered. Okay. Okay, ni tajuk terusnya 17, End of Life Vehicle Management, a Comprehensive Review. The study almost exclusively considered cost or profit as its only objective function. Exact solution methods are mostly provided. However, the vast majority review study were illustrated in either small or medium size cases. Okay, tajuk ke-18, sustainability of marine parks in knowledge, attitude, behavior still relevant? Okay, dia mulakan permulaan ayat. Tadi ayat kedua ni ayat pertama terus. However, empirical support for KAB theory is still lacking and the linear relationship is considered too simplistic. Dia beritahu berdasarkan support empirical of KAB theory is still lacking and their linear relationship is considered is too simplistic. Okay, ada kat sini nak beritahu masih lagi kurang. Dan kajian linear relationship pun simple lagi. Simple sangat. So kita boleh explore more and more. Okay, tajuk yang ke-19, effect of low carbon waste practice on job satisfaction of site managers through job stress. Okay, kat sini, it can thus be argued that since compared to others alternative, there are both direct economy as well as other advantage to source reductions, the rule can also be applied in construction waste. However, the high potential of construction material will be reused on site and recycled off site. Okay. Tajuk yang ke-20, efficiency, productivity and competitiveness of the Malaysia insurance sector and analysis of risk-based capital regulations. Okay. The input price for labor and business service can either be represented by average wage or the ratio personal expenses to the number of employee. However, data on the average wage and the number of employee in Malaysia insurance industry are not available. Okay, so kita tahu satu situasi tapi keadaan dia di Malaysia dalam konteks industri ini adalah tiada lagi. Okay, tajuk ke-21, environment-based virtual interaction to enhance motivation of STEM education, the qualitative interview design and analysis. Okay, di permulaan ayat juga gunakan however. However, previous simulation are used to visualize certain querying activity. Jadi gunakan perkataan permulaan ayat dalam perenggan gunakan however pun boleh. Ini contoh lain. Dah dua dah. Ini contoh yang kedua. Contoh yang satu lagi tu ayat kedua. Ini ayat pertama terus. Okay, tajuk yang ke-22, a qualitative study on the implementation of family health team, the perspective of provider and patients. Okay, there was improved access to the healthcare service, greater internal coordination, broader scope of service provision, as well as enhance patient centeredness and patient support and show the most improvement in diabetes care compared to others primary care method in Canada. However, in Hong Kong, health seeking behavior did not fulfill the family doctor concept despite public understanding on the concept. Okay, dia tunjukkan kenapa kita nak mengkaji benda ni. Okay, tajuk 23, the challenge and opportunities of the global health crisis, the management and business implication of COVID-19 from the ASEAN perspective. Okay, kat sini kan, dia mulakan ayat, the pandemic is the still an ongoing issue in the estimate provided by international institutions such as International Monetary Funds and the World Bank are being revised every week to reflect real-time information. However, previous experience suggests that heterogeneity in national economic structure and trade network may result in each country facing different consequence. Okay, tajuk 24, address global sustainability challenge, a qualitative study on factors that promote transformative learning in engineering students. Okay, among these, the experience reflects learned pattern to experiential learning in considered as more of an ideology than a philosophy or theory of experiential learning. However, COP-ELT is still the most well-known attempt at elaborating experiential learning and in useful as starting point for understanding phenomena. Okay. Okay, tajuk yang ke-25, knowledge perceived barrier and facilitator of medication error reporting a quantitative survey in Malaysia primary care clinics. Okay, ME are the most common type of medical error that occur across the healthcare organization. However, in many countries, they are mostly underreported. Itu satu. Ada yang kawan satu lagi. However, failure to report ME limit the development of prevention strategies. Okay, itu saja perkongsian kita untuk siri yang ke-19 hingga 23. Banyak contoh-contoh however, of course, kalau orang yang nak belajar ni tak puas. Dan kita tadi berapa? Lastly, 25 contoh perenggan yang menggunakan however, saya sendiri pun tak puas. Kalau dapat sampai 100 pun seronok. At least we learn and learn. Apa yang kita boleh summarize, penggunaan however merupakan perkataan yang penting bagi penilai. Especially dia sangat suka dengan perkataan however. So bila katakan however sebenarnya secara tidak langsung kita memang menggunakan keupayaan apply, iaitu menggunakan perkataan analisis dan sintesis, dan itu merupakan satu penulisan kritikal dalam penulisan literature review daripada terlalu direct. Direct maksudnya side and side and side tanpa ada perbincangan, discussion. So however adalah perkataan discussion yang disukai oleh penilai. Okay, gunakanlah semua 25 ni sebagai contoh, sebagai manfaat, supaya you dapat menghasilkan artikel yang baik. Saya doakan semoga penulisan artikel you all dipermudahkan dan berjaya untuk terbit, insyaAllah. Okay, terima kasih lagi sekali. Mohon maaf, banyak bahasa saya English mungkin sebutan saya tak betul. Saya mohon maaf. Okay, atas kesilapan itu, kita jumpa untuk siri akan datang. Assalamualaikum, terima kasih dan selamat sejahtera, selamat malam. Okay, terima kasih semua.